Good morning, and welcome to the Fort Richmond Collegiate Grad Diploma Pickup for the graduates of 2020. Mrs. Gray, Ms. Skelton, and Mr. Manis look forward to presenting graduates with their diplomas today, June 24th, and tomorrow, June 25th, at the school. Welcome, graduates and families. The following videos bring greetings and well wishes from the Pembina Trails School Division trustees, the superintendent of Pembina Trails, FRC school principal, and our class of 2020 valedictorian. And to end with, a short video of fond memories of Fort Richmond Collegiate and the graduating class of 2020.
Hello, graduates. Well, you've done it. You've completed high school. You've demonstrated that you're both determined and resilient. And I don't just mean in the last 4 months. We're so very proud of each and every one of you. Congratulations to you, our Pembina Trails class of 2020.
Congratulations, graduates of 2020. You did it. You've reached a milestone in your life. Your perseverance during these unprecedented times has made you resilient and has prepared you for the future challenges that you will face. This is a stepping stone to achieving a bright future. Best of luck and good health. Stay safe.
Dear Pembina Trails graduates, you have been resilient, you have been courageous, and you did it. My wish for you is that you always pursue your passions, that you dream big, and that you always remember you are part of the Pembina Trails family. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Hey, Pembina Trails graduating class of 2020. Tim Johnson, trustee, wishing you future success and congratulations on reaching this milestone achievement. All the best to you and your family. Stay healthy and take care.
Ordinarily, I would be going to the school to do this in person, but this has turned into a year that required a new adaptation for many things, and you are a generation that can manage it. I have been a teacher for over 40 years and have been meeting my former students who already graduated wherever I go. You also will continue to go forward till you graduate in your field of choice. I wish you good health and happiness and comfort and congratulate you for your success and look forward to meeting you in the future and hearing about all your accomplishments.
Hello, Pembina Trails grads. 2020 certainly has been a memorable year. COVID-19 has impacted everything, including traditional graduation ceremonies, but that does not take away from your accomplishments. You have completed grade 12. I wish you much success and happiness in all your future endeavors. Congratulations, Felicitacion.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. This has been your year, and what a year it's been. During high school, you've had an opportunity to learn and grow, to accept challenges, and take on a wide array of activities. I hope you've had an incredible time. Enjoy your summer, stay safe, good luck with your future.
Hello to the graduating class of 2020. We're so incredibly proud of your hard work and determination. We wish you joy and success as you take on the next chapter of your life. You will be remembered and you will be missed. Have a great summer.
Congratulations, class of 2020. My name is Ted Franton. I'm the superintendent of Pembina Trails School Division. And along with my colleagues and senior administration, I'm bringing you our warmest congratulations. You've had an amazing year. To say that this has been an unusual year would be a gross understatement. We are living in surreal times. Words like courage, angst, flexibility, adaptability, and change have been used and perhaps overused. I'm fond of looking back 18 years on the occasion of graduation ceremonies. I like to paint a picture of what the families were going through when you were born. 18 years from now, there's no question that there will be one word that sticks out, and that word will be COVID. But I'm also hoping that the courageous Black Lives Matter movement is enduring as well. So just to keep people focused on what was going on in 2002 to help you remember, I'm going to give you a short list. Who can forget Wayne Gretzky's Lucky Looney, buried deep in the ice at Center Ice in Salt Lake City during the Olympic Games when Canadian men and women won the gold medal in ice hockey? It was a great time. And of course, sadly, there was no shortage of wars and skirmishes around the world. The euro became the official currency. Brazil won the World Cup, Detroit won the Stanley Cup. And who knew that a cricket tournament could be rained out, and the World Championships were stopped, and Sri Lanka and India were named as co-winners. Chiang Kai-shek was our prime minister. George W. Bush was the president of the United States. And we were just months into post 9/11. I remember vividly like it was yesterday. And there was a whole new normal at our airports because we lived in fear of terrorism, not that different than the fear we have now of another hidden enemy. As you can see from the list, while 2020 will forever be etched in our minds as a special and surreal year, we have much to benefit from those attributes that your parents picked up 18 years ago. I'm thinking specifically of resilience, grit, courage, and adaptability. Those four factors, commingled with a healthy dose of luck and good fortune, have brought you to this exceptional occasion upon your graduation from Pembina Trails Schools. Well done, congratulations, and I want to wish you the very best as you launch the next adventures in your lives.
My name is Janet Gray, and I am the very proud principal of Fort Richmond Collegiate. It is an honor and a privilege to speak to you today as we celebrate the graduating class of 2020. This is also an opportunity for me, and on behalf of my administrative colleagues, Gemma Skelton and John Manis, to be able to share our thanks and appreciation. Thank you to all the staff of Fort Richmond Collegiate and Pembina Trail School Division who have been instrumental in providing a school setting that is safe and clean and supports learning. Educational assistants, office staff, custodians, library staff, divisional support staff, all of these people care about you, our students, and work hard to help you succeed. A special shout out to our faculty members. Teachers really determine the caliber of a school, and I know we all agree that FRC has inspiring, dedicated, and progressive faculty members. Please join me in thanking our teachers. Graduates, I would like to start by congratulating each and every one of you. You have worked long and hard to achieve this goal, and you deserve every bit of excitement you are feeling right now. You might be watching this with family and friends, so please take a minute to thank them. Every graduate here today has people who have been their support system, whether parents, friends, FRC staff members, or others. Thank you, everyone. Sometimes things aren't easy. We have FRC families and students who have overcome incredible adversity to graduate this year. And then all high school students juggle courses and activities and sometimes part-time jobs. It's a lot. We recognize and acknowledge and applaud your hard work. Every single one of you should be happy with your high school accomplishments because you did the best you could do. And also important is that you had fun along the way. High school is not the final you. Take the lessons you have learned and do even better and inspire others along the way. Key to this is asking for help and advice. If you need help, go get it. People succeed because they are persistent and work hard and learn from their mistakes. Fort Richmond Collegiate has a graduating class of over 400 students. That is massive and amazing. What is also amazing is the diversity and brilliance and perseverance and goodness of these graduates. It is important to acknowledge that for the graduates of 2020, these few months did not go as planned. Who knew that March break would be extended and extended and extended? And yet it happened and we survived and we have learned so much. Life as it is, rather than life as you wanted it to be, has maybe been the best training ground for becoming independent and functional adults. You were forced to be independent, and you made it happen, and you should be proud. You have found success in a very trying time,
and the grit you have displayed is an inspiration for us all. Through COVID-19, we learned what matters. The people of Manitoba, including you, learned that by listening to the advice of scientists and medical experts, they can make a difference. Learn from this. Whole-scale positive change can happen, and happen quickly. Everyone played a part, and we saw a positive result. Good for you, grads. We learned that Black lives matter. The world has risen up against racism, and the movement against anti-Black racism has also heightened movements against anti-Indigenous racism and so many others. Grads of 2020, you must carry this forward and oppose and address racism of any kind. We learned that we have different learning styles. Some students and teachers really enjoyed learning from home. Some found it difficult. We also learned that technology can assist learning in some ways, and it can be a hindrance. Any way you look at it, we all learned about technology during this time. We learned that you can make the worst of a situation or the best of a situation. Grads, you made the best of a situation. You tried your best while learning from home. You spent more time with your family. You enjoyed the togetherness and bonding every single day, right? In some ways, you may have connected with your teachers in unique ways that were as good, and in some cases, better than normal. I'm not trying to pretend that everything was perfect and wonderful. It wasn't. But you did learn that you can survive a world-changing event because you have, and you are here to prove it. You are part of the history of Manitoba, and the class of 2020 will not be forgotten. Grads of 2020, you are unique, you are strong, you will be remembered, and you will remember. You will go forth and make a positive difference as Centurions, as Winnipeggers, as Manitobans, as Canadians. We are proud of you. Congratulations.
Hello, I'm Rachel Teller, and I have the privilege of being your valedictorian for the Fort Richmond Collegiate Class of 2020. My family used to tell me how cool it was that I'd be a graduate of this year. 2020 did always have a nice ring to it. As a kid, it sounded like an important year, promising, and full of opportunity. Little did we know. All jokes aside, maybe it can be some of these things. I know, fellow graduates, it might feel like the last thing you need right now is another attempt at an inspiring message. It seems like we've heard it all. We've spent time grieving the loss of our final semester together as seniors and many of the events that it comes with. We've heard sympathetic messages from family through the phone and seen numerous videos from celebrities on social media titled Message for Our Seniors or Dear Class of 2020. We've been told we'll be stronger because of this, that we'll be more prepared than others because life is full of disappointments and we've encountered one early on in our lives. But all these words of wisdom, although well-intended, were only minimally comforting, and most just left us confused on how to feel and uncertain about the future. I say let's look back fondly on the time that we did have, celebrate our achievements, and look forward to the next chapter of our lives. We've been preparing for this for over 12 years, and despite every obstacle, pandemic or smaller, we made it. I think that's pretty amazing. So how did we do it? If you asked me in September how I would describe the class of 2020, I wouldn't even know where to begin. But this past year has made it especially obvious how resilient, talented, hardworking, and capable we are. It's a class where we excel as students, athletes, musicians, leaders, and teammates. We have an incredible amount of individual strength, but can also work together and show up to support each other. Our strong Centurion pride and spirit created some memorable moments as a class this year, like showing our support at varsity sports games, which tended to include face paint, shouting, drumming, and other forms of obnoxious noise making, and occasionally storming the court between games to face off against the opposing school. There were also multiple occasions of impromptu hallway concerts from band and choir. These had some students stopping to dance, sing, or just enjoy the music, and others awkwardly and often unsuccessfully trying to get to class on time. This class is also one of diverse individual talent, exhibited through the clubs and student groups run on every imaginable topic, and events like coffee houses, talent shows, photography and art exhibitions, drama productions, science fairs, and concerts where we are continually impressed by our peers. The specific achievements of this graduating class have been incredible across a wide variety of these programs at FRC. The varsity girls basketball team won the West Winnipeg Athletic Conference, and one of their players was recognized as Female Player of the Year for Manitoba. The boys hockey team were Price Division champions, and the boys indoor soccer team were Premiership champions. We also have many incredible athletes who have been asked to play for colleges and universities across the country. In our science program, we had two of our own place in the top three for Manitoba in the Canadian Chemistry Contest. And a number of students travel across the globe to share research projects of their own. A graduate in the FRC Drama Program was one of the winners of a provincial playwriting competition for her production, Coe's Coffee Shop. The Symphonic Band, Wind Ensemble, and Senior Jazz all received top scores from every judge and outstanding performance awards at the Optimist Music Festival. This list of just a few of the incredible accomplishments proved that FRC's class of 2020 stands out among others. And there's a good chance you already know a future celebrity. As students, we work hard for these accomplishments, but there were also many helpful and influential people along the way who deserve credit. For every favorite subject, there's a teacher who stayed behind to make sure the concept was understood. A teacher who taught with a love and enthusiasm that made us want to stick around, and a teacher who went out of their way to come up with real-life applications, experiments, or analogies, no matter how crazy they seemed. Teachers, thanks to you, our favorite subjects have become our passions, and hopefully someday our careers. We owe all staff and teachers an especially big thank you for adapting to the circumstances this past semester. As the students observed, and we're sometimes entertained by, technology comes to some a bit easier than others. So, whether you made video lessons at home, where we were happily interrupted by your pets, consistently checked up on us to make sure we were okay, which we know is sometimes just to see who is actually looking at your posts, or hosted video calls where you patiently sat in silence staring at initials when no one answered your question, we are grateful. We owe an equally big thank you to the parents and guardians who helped us get to where we are today. We maybe owe a little apology as well for having to put up with us more than you anticipated recently. Most of the time we were shut up in our rooms doing schoolwork, but you also toughed out hearing us play the same 20 measures of a band song for 43 takes, or clanging around the kitchen baking banana bread while you were trying to work or sleep. Thank you for attempting to correct our meandering sleep schedules and reminding us what day of the week it was. You tolerated our irritable moods and tried to understand and comfort us when we were feeling grief, stress, or anxiety. We don't tell you often enough how grateful we are for your support in all of our academic and extracurricular endeavors. And as much as there have been incredible people in our lives to guide us, there were also many lessons that us graduates learned on our own. It's important that we recognize how our experiences have helped us grow and prepare for the future. To finish off, here are 8 things that we've been taught from these tough last few months. Number 1, even better than doing work the night before is doing it the day of. For online school, we made sure to take full advantage of this. Of course, we realize it doesn't work in most real life applications, so maybe it's not the best lesson after all. Number 2, things rarely ever go as planned. We were reminded of this through AP exams, EDSB tests, and the words due to these unprecedented circumstances. Number 3, technology can never fully replace human interaction. It makes connecting with people convenient and easy, sometimes, but is never quite as fulfilling. Number 4, enjoy spending time with yourself. Suddenly having much more time alone taught us how valuable it is to be able to enjoy our own company and want to take care of ourselves physically and mentally as much as we do others. Through this, we learn more about how we function independently, which was good preparation for those planning to move away or move out. Number 5, self-discipline is important where structure lacks. Quite a few of us lacked both during online school. Teachers, remember how you always told us about how independent things become in the post-secondary and work world? Well, don't fret, because now we're very aware of how we function running on our own agendas, and whether or not it's something we need to be concerned about. Number 6, no one else's advice will be perfect for your life and your circumstances. Listen to yourself as much as others. Of course, listen to your parents, teachers, and bosses. But when seeking advice, take it with a grain of salt. I wouldn't blame you if you don't even listen to my advice. There seem to be an endless amount of people telling us how we should be spending our time, how we should be feeling, or how we should be coping. No two people experience things exactly the same way, so we can't expect to take others' advice word for word, or try to follow directly in someone else's footsteps. That's not to say people don't have valuable things to share, but adapt the lessons to your situation. Listen to you. Number 7, Gen Z is a force to be reckoned with. Recent world events have proven that our generation is one that will not stay silent when we hear injustice. We will fight until those in power make changes for the better, or until we're the ones in power and can do it ourselves. Number 8, appreciate the routine things. We've all realized how much we took things like time with friends, getting to go to school, or going out to eat for granted. But there are smaller things that we didn't realize had an impact on our day. There are the less close friends that you only ever talked with in a specific class or surrounded in the halls. The daily greeting from your favorite teacher, or that place you went during lunches and spares where you could always count on finding a friend. Pausing to reflect on your gratitude for every small occurrence during your day is unrealistic for most. But if we all just took a little more time to recognize that the things that are a given in our daily routines are as worth being grateful for as the big things, then we can be happier, kinder, and more present people. So I told you I understood how much you don't need another attempt at an inspiring message, but here we are. So if you choose to remember one piece of advice, let it be the words of Booker T. Washington. Success is to be measured not so much by the position that one has reached in life, as by the obstacles which he has overcome while trying to succeed. I also said to take advice with a grain of salt, so do with this what you will. But I believe this quote can teach us that all things, both success and failure, are temporary. Success is not definable on its own, and the obstacles we face are not permanent or assigned to stop. It might seem negative to say that success is temporary, but listen to this. If we measured our lives by one goal, if we believe that there's one thing that we can achieve that will set us up for life, we will be disappointed. Instead, we need to celebrate the small victories along the way towards a larger goal and realize that these are the things that shape our characters. Imagine if we'd spent the past 12 years believing that getting these diplomas was the only goal we're succeeding at. Of course, it's an amazing accomplishment. That's why we're here today. It's why all those years of school were worth it. But we didn't just succeed at graduating. We succeeded at becoming more knowledgeable, at making friendships to last a lifetime, and at overcoming every obstacle we encountered along the way. And the success that we had today will be developed tomorrow as we continue to learn. Success can't be measured alone because it relies on our past and is being continually built upon. Let's celebrate this class and what we have overcome, and know that this is only one of many great things lying ahead for us. With that, I say goodbye to UFRC, and one last time, congratulations, class of 2020.
Hi, I'm Isabella.
And I'm Isabella.
And you guys may know us as
Izzy Squared.
Ever since we walked through the FRC doors, it has felt like a school, but more like a home to us.
Even though this wasn't much of a senior year, we want to take a moment to look back at all of our memories we have together.
We know going through this year has been really tough for all of us,
but look at all we've accomplished so far.
We want to thank the staff for supporting us throughout all these years.
We love and appreciate you all so much.
Think of this as a final farewell to everyone, to the class of 2020.
I will fight.
I will fight. I mean, so for the first 4 minutes, it's great. There's
not a lot of people here.
Your first day going.
Just got here. So it's exciting.
Senior season.
I will stay. I will stay with you. We'll make it to the other side. Like lovers do. I'll reach my hands out in the dark and wait for yours to interlock. I'll wait for you. I'll wait for you. Cause I'm not giving up. I'm not giving up, giving up. No, not yet.
So much.
Goodbye, grads of 2020. We already miss you.
Congratulations! Get your logs done.
And my favorite memory from grade 12 was probably drama and doing our musical, because that's as close as we got to grad show.
I know, I understand, it's just not how I planned for it to go. 12 years went by.
My favorite memory of FRC is going to Banff last year for the choir trip.
My favorite memory of FRC was probably meeting so many new people and making so many more buds.
One last time, didn't know. I didn't know.
And participating in lots of clubs that FRC has to offer.
My favorite memory from FRC is probably the grad barbecue, because I got to meet lots of new people there.
The best was yet to come, but we will be together.
Favorite FRC memory was taking on the ship in our senior year of hockey.
I wanna walk across the stage, I wanna hug someone goodbye, with everyone I love standing by my side.
Some of my favorite memories at FRC include being involved with the school's clubs, like all their extracurriculars.
One of my favorite high school memories would have to be seeing everyone and coming together as a grade.
Just so bizarre, here we are.
My favorite memory at FRC would have to be going to Edmonton with the JV team in grade 10.
My favorite memory about FRC is probably just like everyday things.
And my favorite memory this year was going to the varsity girls basketball game.
My grade 10 Brendan tournament.
Mr. Reed's class.
When I brought my dog in for a project.
Probably getting kicked out the library. Just anything in the calf.
You're watching the guys hockey team win the championship.
I was getting free pancakes at the church after exams.
So going on the school ski trip to Fernie.
Watching some of the basketball and soccer games and cheering on our team.
Gym honors with Mr. P.
Going on school trips, so going to Fernie and going to Europe.
Spring choir concert and the church trip.
And the boys won the hockey championship.
Grad photos.
All the times we ran in the freezing cold to get Tim's before class.
I went to England with High Altitude Balloon Club.
Choir trips. And also culture day. Our very last senior choir concert.
Standing by my side. Cause we all go our separate ways. And I hope I don't forget those days. No, I don't wanna end this way. Oh, I don't wanna end this way. And despite the moments we can't have, I won't forget the ones we had. Oh, I don't wanna end this way. No, I don't wanna end this way. Cause we were waiting for the day. And all the things that we would celebrate, they said the best was yet to come, but we won't be together when it's done. I wanna walk across the stage, I wanna hug someone goodbye, with everyone I love standing by my side. I wanna walk across the stage, I wanna hug someone goodbye, with everyone I love standing by my side.